Hello, hello, hello. Here follow the solutions of problem 237. I call it a new version because there was a mistake in the old version. With my apologies. So here follows the correct version. A boat with pirates moves in a river with speed V1 relative to the land. Water in the river stands still. A police boat wants to intercept the pirate boat, but its speed is only 2/3 V1. The police boat leaves at point A under an angle alpha to catch the pirates. At what angles of alpha can the police intercept the pirate? That is the problem. Forget B and C, they were trivial. There were only 4 or 5 correct solutions. This was the first correct one by Fersen Tapramos. And Keith Urban was willing to put it for me in writing. So here you see the river, and here you see point A from where the police boat starts. The blue line is the trajectory of the pirates. Now, are you ready for this? The police boat starts at A and goes off in a random direction. I mention random. There's nothing special about this angle alpha. Fersen has chosen just a random alpha. You could put it here, you could put it there, he put it there. The question is, if they catch the pirates at point O, which we assume is the case here, then you know where the pirates were when the boat left. Because the speed of the pirates is V, but the speed of the boat from the police is only 2/3. In other words, you know that the pirates were here. You can draw a circle around point O through A, and that circle has radius R. You now draw a circle point A with radius 1.5 R. That's this circle. And that means that the pirates were at point B. So I will repeat myself. You choose a random angle of alpha, any alpha you want to take. You can take it in this direction, or in this direction. And then you determine where the pirates catch, where the police catches the pirates. That is point O, and the angle is alpha. You now know where the pirates were when the police boat started at A. And that must be in B. Because the pirates traveled this distance, BO, while the police traveled this distance, AO. And BO must be 1.5 times larger than AO, because the speed of the pirate boat is V1 and the speed of the police boat is only 2/3. so that this penetrates in your brains, this picture, and acknowledge that I can choose any angle of alpha, and the picture that you see here is relevant. That means any angle of alpha will work. If alpha is here, then O is here. Then this is the radius. So point B is then 1.5 times this distance from this point. You can go in the same direction here. Pick a random alpha, there is always a solution. That's why I mentioned in my second problem that this is really a trivial problem. Because the answer is any angle will work between 0 and 180 degrees. So nothing special has to be done. Of course, you have to know, you have to assume that the police knows where the pirates are at any moment in time. They can do that by radio or whatever enemy, whatever way that is. Any angle you choose, any angle here, any here, any here, any there, will work. If alpha is close to 0 degrees, there is a solution, but of course, the distance that the police boat may have to travel may be 30 miles. So the river has to be very long. No problem. They will still be able to catch the pirates, assuming that the river, again, as I said, continues all that distance. So, let us now look at the wording from Verzen. So here follows the solution by Verzen Trappos, which was written up nicely by Keith. The reason why I made a new drawing is only because in this picture you can't see the circles very well. And I made those circles very dark. But I chose exactly the same points, of course, point A, point O, point A and B. Police boat travels in a random direction, alpha. You can now calculate, using these two circles, where the pirates had to be at the moment that the boat left, that the police boat left. So let's now look at Verzen's text. Again, it's a bit faint. I didn't have the time to retype it larger. So let me read it slowly. Let's start by assuming a solution and working backwards. These are the words by Verzen Trappos. Suppose the police intercept the pirates at point O along the pirates' path. Draw a circle centered at O, passing through the police start point A. At that moment, the pirates were at a distance 3/2 OA, along the line through O, parallel to the riverbank. So if the police boat is here at O, the pirate boat must have been here. That's non-negotiable. The intersection always exists for any angle alpha. He excludes 0 to 180 degrees. It's nice that he excludes 0. But a pubic hair above 0 would be fine. So I call that any angle. Any angle. Any angle in this direction, which would be extremely close to 0 in the extreme case, and in this direction, which would be 180 degrees in an extreme case here. So the solution basically is that any angle between 0 and 180 degrees is correct. They can always, the police can always catch the pirates. There exists a starting point or time allowing the police to intercept. The solution is independent of the river's speed, since boat speeds are relative to water, and we can always handle the problem in the river frame anyway. So my question B and C are irrelevant. Question B and C dealt with the case that there was velocity of the water. So Fersen recognizes that those two questions are really irrelevant because you can always choose the reference frame of the river. Likewise, regardless of the police boat speed relative to the pirates, there is always a time to start the chase. Those slower boats must start earlier. Now, I maintain that this was an easy problem if only you recognize that at any angle there is a solution. And so all the nonsense that so many students have, this cos-squares, one over sine-squares, one over tangent-squares, all that is utter nonsense. Any angle works. That's why it is a trivial problem. How many people had this right? About 4 or 5, no more. Many others came up with a nightmare of solutions, trigonometric solutions, which are all wrong. Okay. Thank you, Kees, for writing it up. And by all means, thank you, Fersen, Tapramas, for coming up with the very first brilliant solution. In my book, not only brilliant, but let's face it, the only sensible solution.